Father, we ask your blessing on Miles and Mary at this time, not only on today, this special day, but throughout their entire life. We ask also, Father, that you send your Holy Spirit into their hearts from this day forward for all their days on this earth, and that unite all of us with that same Holy Spirit for all the days of our life, so that we may share in the joy of this day for both Miles and Mary. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
The first reading is a reading from the book of Genesis. Yahweh God said, "It is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helpmate." So from the soil, Yahweh God fashioned all the wild beasts and all the birds of heaven. These he brought to the man to see what he would call them. And each one was to bear the name the man would give it. The man gave the names to all the cattle, all the birds of heaven, and all the wild beasts. But no helpmate suitable for man was found for him. So Yahweh God made the man fall into a deep sleep. While he slept, he took one of his ribs and enclosed it in flesh. Yahweh God built the rib he had taken from the man into a woman and brought her to the man. The man exclaimed, "This at last is bone from my bones and flesh from my flesh. This is to be called woman, for this was taken from man. And this is why a man leaves his father and mother and joins himself to his wife, and they become one body." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The second reading is taken from St. Paul's letter to the Corinthians. "If I have all the eloquence of men and of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are, and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but I am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end." And this, too, is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I have about 45 minutes of talk prepared, but we'll cut it a little shorter. There's a lot of things that I think I could say. It's a very special occasion for me, as I think Mary knows. The first reading, of course, is pretty obvious. You know, the fact of man and woman being different and yet alike, and being so conflicted at times. Women going to the cave? No. Women going to other women to talk, men going to the cave, men from Mars, women from Venus, whatever it is. Those are all things that we're very aware of. Second reading, of course, the famous reading from St. Paul about what love is. And when I was thinking about those two things, and I thought, well, now, what can I really say? What can I really, give you? And there wasn't anything that I could come up with, except this is the age of the computer. I can turn the computer on. I can turn it off. My kids will set my VCR for us. They will even set my digital clock on me, because that's about as far as I can go. But what hit me was, when we're talking about love, and love is patient, is kind, is not resentful and boastful, you know, it's all well and good, and that's fine. But how? How do you do it? And what kept hitting me and was very strong with me is that there's got to be a way, and what is the way? Well, and this gets to the computer end of things, I think just recently, in the last 3 or 4 weeks, it finally dawned on me what www.com, www.com, all this stuff, what it means. I, you know, it's just something that you hear, and it finally kind of got to me, and I thought, wait a minute, www. Okay, World Wide Web, that makes sense. So, com, communication, all this. So then, you know, what really hit me was like, well, okay, how are we going to do this love routine? How are you two going to survive for the remainder of your days on this earth? What's the secret? How can you do it? It's easy. It's on a computer. It's on your eternal computer. www.jd.com/milesandmary. What would Jesus do for Miles and Mary? So when you run into those tough spots, that they're there. And I'm reminded of the tough spots. You know, we don't like to talk about tough times when we're at an occasion like this, but let's be real. You know, this euphoria is not going to last for the rest of your days. There's going to be some hard work and some tough times. I'm reminded of a picture of a friend of mine up in Columbia who has a cattle farm. And, he has a picture of a very, you know, peaceful scene, cows grazing, you know. The caption underneath of it says, you know, some days you step in it, some days you don't. And it kind of stuck with me, and, you know, it's like, yeah, it says it all, you know, this is what life is really about. And on those days that step in it, that's when we need to draw on that WW, what would Jesus do? And so my wish, my prayer, my hope for you is that you can remember to tie into that web, as we all would like to tie into that web, what would Jesus do on those days that you step in? The hope and prayer that I have is that those days are very, very far in the future. So with that being said, 40 minutes having gone by, are you guys ready to launch your vows? Dear friends, you have come together in this place so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of this community. Christ abundantly blesses his love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so in the presence of this community, I ask you to state your intentions. Miles and Mary, have you come in without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? And will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives? Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and his church. I, Miles, take you, Mary, to be my wife.
I, Miles, take you, Mary, to be my wife.
I promise always to forgive and to trust.
I promise always to forgive and to trust.
To hope.
And to hope.
And to endure.
And to endure. Whatever God comes. As I do now, I will always love you.
I'm married to you. You're my husband. I promise always to forgive and to trust.
I promise always to forgive and to trust. I promise always to forgive and to trust.
Thank you. You have declared your consent before this community. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. But God has joined, man must not divide.
Amen.
Lord, bless and consecrate Miles and Mary in their love for each other, and may these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other and always remind them of their love through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Mary, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
Mary, take this ring as my sign of love.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
So
it won't come off. It won't come off that easy.
There you go.
The engagement ring off.
Miles, take this ring as a sign of love. Let us turn to the Lord and pray that he will bless with his grace Mary, now Mary, in Christ to this man Miles, and that he will unite in love the couple he has joined in his holy bond. Father, by your power, you have made everything out of nothing. In the beginning, you created the universe and made mankind in your own likeness. You gave man the constant help of woman, so that man and woman should no longer be two but one flesh. And you teach us that what you have united may never be divided. Father, you have made the union of man and wife so holy a mystery that it symbolizes the marriage of Christ and his church. Father, by your plan, man and woman are united, and married life has been established as the one blessing that was not forfeited by original sin or washed away in the flood. Look with love upon this woman, your daughter, now joined to her husband in marriage. She asks your blessing. Give her the grace of love and peace. May she always follow the example of the holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband put his trust in her and recognize that she is his equal and the heir with him to the life of grace. May he always honor her and love her as Christ loves his bride, the church. Father, keep them always true to your commandments. Keep them faithful in marriage and let them be living examples of Christian life. Give them the strength which comes from the gospel so that they may be witnesses of Christ to others. And after a happy old age, grant them fullness of life with the saints in the kingdom of heaven. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
God, the eternal Father, keep you in love with each other so that the peace of Christ may stay with you and be always in your home. Amen. May your friends console you and all men live in peace with you. Amen. May you always bear witness to the love of God in this world so that the afflicted and the needy will find in you generous friends and welcome you into the joys of heaven. Amen.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And now, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May he be gracious unto you and cause his face to shine upon you. In your laughter and your tears, in your labor and your leisure, in your going out and in your coming in, in sickness and in health, until you come to stand with Jesus on that day when you see us from sunset. Amen. Friends, I now present Mr. and Mrs. Miles Crane.
Wow.
This is the first time. Now, it's been quite a few weddings that I've officiated at, but this is the first time I didn't have to prompt the bride and groom to commit their love to each other. And that says an awful lot. That's a party.
Well, it's my honor to be here to share with Miles and Mary. The joys of the day as Miles' best man. Now, to have a successful marriage, they tell me that you have to find the right person. But I think that you must be the right person. And you take Mary and Miles, they are both right for each other. And they will have a happy life. Now, I thought I would recognize the family members. Don't get mad at me. There's Mary's mother, Tuck.
That's me.
And her daughters, Megan and Aaron. And her sister, Paula and Dave. There's an aunt, Bess.
Thank you.
And an aunt, Grace, and two cousins that their probationary officer would not allow their names to be spoken. So, Dougie and Deborah, I'm not kidding.
My ribs hurt.
We went to the hospital.
Oh, jeez.
He had some problem getting oxygen to his brain. So, when he was discharged from the hospital, the first thing he wanted to do was get married. I don't know if there's any connection, but I could be. That's our toast. They're beautiful bridesmaids. We adore them for their beauty. We respect them for their abilities. And say a toast to Mary, our lovely bride. We welcome her into our family as her new daughter-in-law. And to the bride and groom, we wish them love for the rest of their life. And may they have a happy, healthy, and long life together, and may the blessings of this day last forever. And now we present Mr. and Mrs. Miles Kramer, and we give them our blessings as they go. Drink up.
You want to come for it, Abby?
This one hurts.
Yeah.
Great.
Now those cousins are
dead. No, Bert, you did good.